try.
All right, hers is gonna be more fun because I'm filming her. You ready?
Wait, you could just leave it right there though, because you're in my light.
No, because I'll be able to. Because I'm in your light. Yeah. There we go. Because I'll be able to zoom in on the.
Open it. Okay, so the first one.
You want to say the name?
It's Jay Official. Hey, girl, saw your video on Instagram, so I wanted to take the opportunity to ask you if you had any advice for me as I make my national debut as a bikini competitor next week. I'll be doing June USA's next Saturday in South Carolina. Also a natural competitor, and I look up to you very much. So I always get asked that question about advice for a bikini show. My advice is just, I always tell everybody when you step on stage, fake it till you make it. Everybody's nervous. Even I get nervous. I did my 26th pro show today, and I still get nervous before I step on stage. So I say when any competitor stepping on stage, act as if you're Miss Olympia on stage. You have to act as if you already won the show, because what it comes down to is who's more confident and who has the best stage presence. Because everybody's coming in nowadays with killer physiques. So what really sets you apart is your personality and really shining on stage, but you have to have that confidence. So even if you're faking it, that's the way you gotta do it. So yeah, that's the hardest thing. See, Dawn K31.
You have suggestions for fighting cravings. And side note, why does everyone have to do such a dark tan? suggestions for fighting cravings. My two things for cravings, honestly, the cravings are gonna be there, especially if you're cleaning.
It's okay, we wing it.
How did you get into the fitness industry?
I think we kind of answered that one.
Yeah, I've kind of already answered that. I started competing at a crazy rate of competing 10 times a year and just got recognized for that, which is not an easy thing to do. Rico Berto 24. You are a very inspiring and what I call fitness model. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Shout out.
Okay, so we're going to do Nick Shalin. Hey, Jess, I've always followed you and your husband. I don't know about the husband thing, but people who like my role models, I just want to know, how do you guys do it? You guys eat a lot of crap and still stay fit. I just don't understand. I eat so healthy and work out every day, but one day I eat wrong. It's the worst. So Aaron, actually, he does the If It Fits Your Macro, so he eats a lot of crappy stuff. When you've seen me eat crappy stuff, like for the last couple months, honestly, like I was having a break from just everything. I didn't want to touch. I just got sick of clean food and I just don't want to touch anything. But, and then when I got into...
I think this is a good point to explain to everyone about flexible dieting, that you were prepping and that you are kind of easing into the flexible dieting lifestyle, because everybody's kind of wondering about that. I thought you were doing flexible dieting.
Oh,
are
yeah.
you doing it?
So if I'm doing flexible dieting or not, the thing is I believe that there has to be a happy, like, a balance. So when I was like, if it fits your macros, I could just eat whatever. Like, I was eating everything and it was still fitting my macros, but I wasn't seeing myself lean out as much as I wanted to. So my thing is half eating healthy and half whatever I want, not just one cheat meal a day. That's kind of where I'm going to take it, because I'm not going to be competing now for a while just because I have so much going on in my career. But it's having a balance. You can't always, I mean, you can't eat clean 24/7, you know, 365 days out of the year. You just can't do that. It doesn't keep you sane. It really makes you go crazy. It
makes you talk like that.
Yeah. So when I'm on prep, I'm just like out of it. Like I'm moody. So I was doing it if it fits your macros. But for competing, it's a little bit different. I would say do if it fits your macros into a month out, and then really start eating clean and maybe like one cheat a week. But it all depends on where your body's at in a month out. But that's kind of what I did. I did it until about 3-4 weeks out, and then I started doing what I know best is eating clean and then having a cheat once in a while.
I think you were a little bit nervous about the flexible dieting into a competition, so you just fell back on what you know and what you've done 30 shows with.
Yeah, but I feel also that it's good to maintain what you have. So now after this show, I'm going to go directly into if it fits my macros tomorrow to track what I'm eating. It's a really good way of tracking what you're eating, because when you eat clean, you don't really track what you eat. Well, I don't for the most part. So if it fits your macros, I'm going to do a whole and clean eating versus whatever the whole battle between that. I'm really going to go into depth and tell you guys like how I feel and how my body feels on everything. If that makes any sense.
That's good.
Okay, so write meow 81. Why is this taking forever to upload?
Tap a couple at a time. Tap to load.
Oh, you just tap it.
Yeah, so they can load it multiple, like while you're answering the question.
Oh, well look, it's still not going.
And if you haven't answered those, you can swipe those too.
Oh, okay. Maria underscore 10. How much cardio do you do on and off season? That's a good question. So on season, off season, you normally want to do about 5 days a week, 30 minutes a day. That's what I would recommend. That's probably what I'm going to start doing. Honestly, I was out of the gym for 3 months. I wasn't doing any cardio since I've actually been on Snapchat. So you guys will see me having a more healthier, balanced routine. I kind of just went like girls gone wild, and I literally was like on strike from the gym because I got burnt out. Honestly, I was in the gym 7 days a week, 2 to 3 hours a day. For the last 4 years. So I just got a little burnt out, but I love being in the gym. I love the whole lifestyle. What was the actual question?
How much cardio did you do on and off season?
Oh, and then on season, this last week I was doing 2 hours a day, getting like 3-4 hours of sleep. So it just depends. My body actually wasn't where I wanted it to be a couple weeks ago, so I started doing really high intense cardio. But normally I do about 30 to 40 minutes of cardio about 6-7 days a week when I'm on season.
Okay, we're running out of time, so we're going to do 10 questions, and you get to answer in one sentence or two maximum.
Oh, so Aaron's my director.
One-liners. Here we go. It's going to be fun.
Oh, okay, this girl. Okay, it says, we love you, Jess. Inspiration. Cute dog. Looks like a golden doodle, maybe. Golden retriever and poodle. And that's from Tiana Trey. Thank you, Tiana. And I don't know what that says. It's in like a different language.
Happens.
Huh?
It happens.
Write meow 81.
Hey Jess, my name's Jessica Tew. I look like a scrub. I'm at work. So question, what are your must have like supplements and proteins that you take?
One liner. Must have
BCAAs and protein shakes. That's easier that way. Billy Lee Fitness. I love you. Please like one of my Instagram pictures. Will do.
Billy Lee Fitness, shout out.
Huh?
I'm shouting these people out on YouTube.
Brandy Kroll 1. Hey Jessica, how did you find your macros? FitnessPal, BodyBell.com, what's your source to track and find your macros? And how do you find out and know your BMR in motion is correct? Okay, so I'm going to answer the first one. How did you find your macros? I use my Fitness PayPal, and Aaron actually figured that out for me because that's his thing.
My Fitness PayPal.
My Fitness Pal, whatever. I always get a mix of a PayPal. And Aaron figured that out for me. Like I said, it's something we'll go into detail about too on our next YouTube. Anna Chaka 916, maybe from Sass.
So I have a question. Were you always so skinny, like throughout your childhood and teenage years? I don't know how old you are.
There's two of them.
When are me and Aaron getting hitched? I like that one. Okay, so I was 93 pounds throughout high school. I was a runner, like I said before, super, super skinny. I have to show you guys like my before and after. But yeah, so I was really like skinny, but it's, people say, oh, it's easier because you were, you weren't like fat and had to lose a bunch of weight. But honestly, when you're that tiny, it is that much harder to actually gain muscle. I feel like people that have more weight on them, naturally have like more muscle because their body has to be able to hold up all the weight. So when they kind of, when they tone down or lean down, they actually have more muscle just naturally. But for me being 93 pounds, I actually had to build the muscle. Now I'm about 110 pounds off season, so I'm up 17 pounds from when I was in high school.
193.
Who is that from? Shoot, Spearhead 2332. I don't know. I guess you gotta look like Aaron. And T.Y. Williams 124. Ah, wait. You look amazing. Thank you. Am I supposed to say that more enthusiastic? Thank you.
Five okay, more.
So you guys make me blush. How do you keep your muscle gains and your abs? This is from Hey She by, how do I keep my muscle gains? You have to be consistent in the gym, and also you have to make sure you're having enough amount of protein. And then how I keep my abs, I actually did 1,000 sit-ups for 2 months straight when I was 14, and they've never went away. That's when my abs were so intense. So if anybody wants abs like me, I challenge you to do 2 months, 1,000 sit-ups every single day without missing.
Say what?
Say what? Okay, Vorkinky.
Good name.
Hi, my name's Tina Vorkink. I love you, and I've watched your pose 1,000 times before my first show. So I want to know who inspired your posing routine.
Who inspired my posing? Since the beginning, Amanda Latona, definitely, she's a dear friend of mine now, but she actually was one of the first people I ever looked up to. I think that's who everybody looked up to. But I honestly, from the gate, I watched several people's routines, and I picked and chose what I liked out of everybody's routine, and then I made it my own, which most people would just completely mimic somebody else, but something that I do even still to this day. I'll even go to amateur shows, and if I like something an amateur girl does, I'll actually put it into my routine. So I'm always doing my homework when it comes to posing.
Last three.
Maldo 317. Okay, that's a band or something. Pris 30. How many shows do you do a year? I've been competing now for a little under 4 years, and I've done 10 shows per year. Two Olympias, 26 pro shows now, 2 national shows, and 2 local shows. I'm sorry, 3 local shows and 2 national shows. This year, I have a lot more on my plate, so I'm not even sure if I'll actually be competing that much or at all this year, because Shreds will have a huge Olympia booth at the Olympia, so it's a priority for me to compete, but as well as to support my company, so I might just enjoy the Olympia this year and just work the booth instead of actually competing. And then this is the last one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, 2 so more.
Rubly. He sold a car to a bodybuilder. Congratulations.
Good job, bro.
And Chasmic Mac. No question. You engaged. I don't know. Am I, Aaron?
I don't see a ring on the finger yet.
What? And Lizzie Cash 3.
I'll start
another
dancing.
Party. Silly Taco. How much weight do you gain from lifting? Did lifting make your legs bigger? How much weight do you
So when you started?
So I've gained 17 pounds basically, which is a lot. Did lifting make your legs bigger? Yes, it did. That's the first thing that grows on me genetically. Filipinos have more muscle mass in their legs, so that's something. My legs did get bigger. Yes.
All right. So that's about it.
Okay. Thanks, you guys. Until next time, I appreciate you guys sending me all your questions, and I definitely want to get more.